Hey, everybody. I was just making myself a latte at home, and I thought I'd share how to do this. I used to be a barista years ago before I became a nurse, and I even went so far after I stopped working in a latte shop. I experimented over the years how to make my own lattes and coffee at home, and I used to own a home barista, a little espresso making machine that I got from Starbucks. It was several hundred dollars, but you know, if you drink a coffee every day at Starbucks, it pays to make them at home. They're so much cheaper. Then I slowly over the years have started becoming more of a minimalist and kind of getting rid of stuff and selling things off. And I actually sold my little espresso maker and stopped drinking coffee altogether for over a year, and then slowly I've been drinking it again. And I thought I would share this super simple way to make how to make like espresso shots without an espresso maker, or just basically super strong coffee with really no special equipment whatsoever. If you can boil a kettle of water, if you have your favorite coffee, you know, the stronger the better, like a French roast or some type of espresso bean. I buy mine in bulk at Costco, and I get decaf because you still get caffeine in coffee anyways if it's decaf, and I don't need extra caffeine. I have lots of energy. And either have them ground, you know, buy them ground already, or if you have a little grinder at home, whatever, but you'll need to grind your beans, the finer the better. But it doesn't necessarily have to be like an espresso grind, which is super fine, but just as fine as you can get it at home. And all you need is boiling water and then a way to strain your grounds. I even passed up on basically a way to do a French, like the French style or Italian style. I can't remember off the top of my head. But there's basically little strainer devices that you can get where you put the grounds in the bottom, add the boiling water, and then you push a plunger down and it has a wire mesh. And I know there's a certain name for it, but I'm horrible with names remembering things. I could have got a brand new one that still had the price tag on it from Starbucks for $40. Well, it was $6 at the Goodwill, but I thought, you know, I have so many kitchen gadgets, I can just make it myself with what I already have. So that's what this video is about, simplifying. Yes, you can totally make your own espresso shots and good tasting coffee. So I'm going to show you. I'm just listening to my favorite YouTubers in the background. This is one of them, Mary's Test Kitchen. But what I do for mine, whatever your favorite little latte cup is. I have a reusable one from Starbucks. If you notice, most of your latte cups will come with lines, and those are kind of to gauge like how much your syrup, where you fill your syrup to, where you add milk or ice. You know, you can just play around with it, but I do use the lines. I add my syrup to the first line, I add my ice to the top line here, and then I fill the rest with my plant milk. And my favorite right now is vanilla flavored soy milk. And for my shots, all I do is add my ground coffee into a Pyrex measuring cup. I usually do about 4 ounces because I like about 4 shots or so. I know it's kind of hard to see on here because of the lighting conditions. But anyways, I do 4 ounces of coffee grounds, and then I fill it up to anywhere between 8 and 12 ounces of water. But I don't add 8 or 12 ounces, because your grounds are going to displace. So I'm really only adding maybe 4 to 8 ounces total. And then just over the course of a few minutes, I stir it every so often, and I just let it steep for about 4 or 5 minutes. I put a little thing on top, little saucer to kind of keep the steam in. And then this is what I use to strain. We already have these. They're just little plastic cones you can get, and then the cone filters. To me, that's about as fancy as I get, but these are very inexpensive. You can buy these. The great thing about how I do this is I don't need any electricity to make this. We've had our power out before, and I can do this on a little propane cook stove. Just all I need to do is boil water, and that's it. So then my shots fill up in here, and you just strain out. It's basically making a super strong coffee.
The espresso machine will put pressurized steamed water through. That's how it extracts and gets that really strong flavor to the coffee. This is obviously going to be a little bit more watery, but if you don't add very much water to your grounds, it's going to be a super concentrated tasting coffee, so you can get that nice coffee flavor. And I just wanted to show also, well, anyways, I just made my own chocolate syrup. I did a video on that. And what I do is I just saved an old Hershey's plastic squirt bottle, and I just reuse it. And I always clean it out with really well and then put boiling water in it. And I use a funnel. Here you can see the remnants. I use a funnel to get my chocolate syrup down into the bottle. But, yeah, I just thought I'd share that. Super easy way how to make your own Starbucks-like latte at home for super cheap, super simple, and get a great tasting product. And save money. Yay!